guard, a 5'7 freshman of Helena, New Jersey. Number 3, Erica Brown. At forward, a 6'1 freshman of St. John, Northern, Canada. Number 12, Hannah Jardine. At forward, a 6-foot freshman of Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. Number 25, Shanice Johnson. At guard, a 5'7 senior of Baltimore, Maryland. Number 15, Akiva Richards. And at center, a 6'3 senior of South Rodney, Virginia. Number 13, Kelsey Buchanan. Coaching staff, the University of Delaware, athletic trainer Kelly Stafford, director of basketball operations Allie Haley.
Play. Their starting lineup the same as in the last game. Erica Brown runs the point. She's averaging 9 points, 3 rebounds per game. She's joined in the backcourt by Akima Richards, the 5'7 senior out of Baltimore, Maryland, who was dynamic in the last contest against UNC Wilmington. Tina Martin calling her a spark plug off the bench. Meanwhile, the small forward is Hannah Jardine, a 6'1 freshman out of Newfoundland, Canada, has at least 6 rebounds in each of her 2 starts during her collegiate career. The power forward, Shanice Johnson, another true freshman out of Chester, PA, 8.5 points, 6.5 boards per game, and a center, Kelsey Buchanan, 17.5 points, 9 rebounds per game, a double-double her last time out. The Hens in the home white jerseys and the blue letters, yellow trim. Meanwhile, Drexel, navy blue jerseys, yellow letters, yellow numbers. Delaware will move from left to right in the opening half. It will be tipping it up. Kelsey Buchanan against Fiona Flanagan. Ball is in the air. Buchanan tips it. It gets batted around. It ends up in her hands. And so Delaware will go to the offensive end first. Erica Brown dribbling towards the right wing. Drexel plays a matchup zone very similar to what Delaware uses. A pass goes left baseline. Shanice Johnson, deep 2, jumper rattled in and out. Rebound grabbed by the Dragons.
And Drexel there doing a fantastic job boxing out. The ball was able to touch the floor because there was no Delaware person able to get by Drexel.
Hens not in their matchup zone here. They go man-to-man against Drexel. Reddick at the high post feeds down low. Curran on the left block over Shanice Johnson, who was late rotating. And it's 2-0 Drexel.
Screen after screen after screen. That's what you're going to see with Drexel. Very surprised that Delaware's coming out in a man-to-man against this Drexel offense.
Here comes Brown on the right wing. Akima Richards dribbling towards the top now. Feeds left side to Hannah Jardine. Foul line left, picks up her bounce. Dishes into the corner. Johnson, touch pass to Buchanan, cutting to the basket. Left hand finish. We're tied at 2.
And that's one of the good things, basically playing against your own zone defense. They hit the short corner. They created space, hit the short corner, and then hit Kelsey Buchanan sliding down in the key.
Better ball movement than we saw the entire game against UNC Wilmington already on the first 2 trips. Flanagan top of the circle, feeding right wing. Open there is the point guard, Creighton. Creighton trying to get it inside, nothing there. Instead, a couple of bounces towards the top. Now feeds Flanagan, left wing to Reddick. She can shoot from outside, not as well as her brother, though. She misses the deep 3. Rebound Richards, racing the other way. Akima at the foul line, stop and pop with a little runner. It's good, and the Hens have a 4-2 edge.
And that was something that Tina Martin talked a lot about leading into this game. They need transition points because of Drexel's defense.
And Richards showed the ability to do that against UNC Wilmington, something that surprisingly has been missing from her game this year. Curran, a deep 2 left side. That's good. Wow, the freshman Sarah Curran showing off some ability in the early going. She has all 4 of Drexel's points.
And Shanice Johnson kind of putting her hands up, looking over at the coaching staff, making sure she's guarding that correctly.
Richards, top of the circle with it the other way for Delaware. Hesitation dribbled. Feeds on the wing to Hannah Jardine. Back to Richards, deep corner to Johnson, cutting towards the post, and she'll bank one in from 10 feet. Caroming off of Reddick, was able to absorb the contact at its 6-4 hand.
Delaware doing a much better job moving without the basketball in this game than they have in the last 3 combined. Great job by Shanice Johnson.
Here comes Drexel the other way. Right wing Reddick, cross court feed in the corner near side Pearson. Pearson to left wing, Creighton up top to Reddick. Reddick surveying her options, feeding off far corner. Flanagan with it. Flanagan cross court, back up top. Curran for 3 and gets the friendly roll. How about that? 7 points to start the game. Drexel back up by 1.
And they might have to look at that matchup. Shanice Johnson having trouble right now getting out on Curran.
Impressive start for the true freshman. Now Jardine off a head pick, driving baseline, tough angle shot, wouldn't go, air ball long. Long rebound chased down by Creighton. The point guard brings it up the other way, looking for some help, feeds off to Curran. Curran passes foul line right to Flanagan. Left-hand dribble towards the top. Lob near corner, finds Creighton. Creighton will circle towards the top of the key. Erica Brown guarding her not all that closely. Feeds off to Reddick. She's going to put up a foot on the line, too. Front rimmed it. And rebound up top to get it to Kima Richards from the guard position.
And Drexel getting a lot of the shots that they want right now. Delaware has to do a better job getting out on those shooters.
Reddick are able to come over and block the shot of Akima Richards, who changed pace nicely but can't go up weak inside against Reddick. She's too big and strong.
Yeah, but I like that she's attacking. I like that Akima Richards is carrying over what she did against UNCW and trying to hit those spots against the zone.
Agree wholeheartedly. She's going to be a big part of this game if Delaware is able to get a win. She has it right wing now, feeds high post to Johnson, puts it on the deck with one bounce, now pulls up for the jumper, wouldn't go. And a backside rebound grab by Pearson for Drexel. Here comes Pearson in the forecourt. She'll dribble right side feed to Reddick, back to Pearson. Moves towards the wing, hand off to Curran. Curran to the foul line on the bounce, right side over to Creighton. Creighton in the corner, Flanagan trying to drive baseline. Cross court feed to Reddick, out to Pearson, triple left wing, back rimmed it, followed her shot, got it back, and found Flanagan to reset things. And this is where Drexel can be dangerous. Off to Curran, hot early, and it continues. Another triple. What a start for Sarah Curran. She's got all 10 of Drexel's points. They lead it 10-6.
You cannot give out offensive rebounds to this Drexel team, because if they miss the first time, they're not going to miss the second time.
Here's Richards, top of the circle. Delaware looking for an answer after six straight points scored here by the Dragons. Up top to Buchanan, couple of dribbles towards the foul line. Her feed was kicked. It'll go out of bounds. It'll stay with Delaware when we return. Timeout on the floor, 15 minutes, 39 seconds left to go in the opening half. Right now it's Sarah Curran 10, Delaware 6. The Hens trail by 4. You're listening to Delaware Basketball on 12 Night of the Ticket and 1410 WDOV.
Basketball. Blue Hens State of Mind on 1290 The Ticket and 1410 WDOV.
15 minutes, 39 seconds left to go in the opening half from the Carpenters Center. Drexel 10, Delaware 6. The pace of the game right now not favoring Delaware. Tina Martin said she wanted it to be in the 50s. We're not on track for that early going.
And actually it's Sarah Curran 10, Delaware 6, because she has all of the points for Drexel.
The Dragons staying in that matchup zone. Delaware ball out of the media timeout. Kelsey Buchanan on the right wing. Alicia Bell checking into the contest, and she'll feed it on the right elbow to Hannah Jardine. Opposite look, left side, deep two from Akima Richards on the wing, wouldn't go. And a long rebound chased down by Creighton. Here she comes the other way, circling towards the top, leaving it off Flanagan. Quick release three, missed it with a flat shot off the left rim. Rebound grabbed by Richards, and she wants to run the other way.
Good job by Akima there. Just hustling to the basketball.
Akima stopping at the three-point line, fighting the point guard, Erica Brown. Good decision there from the senior. Brown, the freshman, dribbling towards the right wing, looking for Buchanan down on the post. Gets it to her baseline right. Head fake on Reddick. Couple of dribbles. Now pulls up and hits. Little eight-foot jumper off the bounce. That's the biggest maturation in Kelsey Buchanan's game.
Yeah, because she can take that step back inside, but her ability to put the ball on the floor is what's making her a great player this year.
And with her athleticism, so difficult to defend. Here's Pearson on the left wing. Richards in front of her, feeding up top to Flanagan. Jardine has that assignment. Back to Pearson, right side. To Reddick, deep two with Buchanan in her face. It rattled out. Jardine, nice rebound there as she ripped it away from her teammate, Alicia Bell.
Nice two-man game there by Drexel. Even though Abby Reddick missed that shot, it was a nice two-man game.
Jardine inside to Buchanan, had it ripped free by Reddick. It went off of her hip, out of bounds, back to Drexel. like the idea from Buchanan, just got to be a little stronger with the ball.
And right now Drexel is going zone on a make and man-to-man on a miss. So they're mixing up their defense. And Delaware has to do a better job with their spacing on those last few possessions.
Test a freshman point guard, try to see if she can identify it right away. Pearson with the ball, top of the circle, giving it off to Creighton. Back to Pearson, left wing triple, good. Rachel Pearson, who loves playing against Delaware, another three, and it's 13-8 Drexel.
You cannot go under the screen against these shooters. You have to go over the top. You cannot sink and go under the screen.
Particularly not Pearson, a 43% three-point shooter, and they call a double dribble there on Akima Richards. Maybe more of a carry. Either way, a turnover gives it back to the Dragons.
Yeah, there's really no shooter on the floor right now. If you're guarding them, that you can go under. You either have to trail or you have to go over the top or through.
And that's what makes Drexel such a tough matchup, is Abby Reddick with it now top of the key. Looking over her options, feeds right wing to Flanagan. Back to Reddick, left wing, triple, in and out. Rebound Brown.
Yeah, Abby Reddick really just kind of can't find the net here. She's 0 for 5 early, but just a little bit short on everyone.
Normally not a big part of her game. She's closer to the basket where she likes to operate. As Richards dribbling here the other way, feeding to Brown, right wing three, back rim. Jardine fighting for the rebound but can't get it free from Reddick with her big frame. Long outlet to Pearson. Pearson, high pass, nice catch by Flanagan on the left block. She'll feed up top to Reddick. Reddick driving to the foul line, out right side. Curran again, this time in and out. Offensive board, Pearson hustling after it and laying it home. Timeout, Tina Martin. Nobody put a body on Rachel Pearson as she came darting in from the perimeter.
It's almost tiring watching Drexel play offense. They just move so well without the basketball. They do all the little things. That's the point of those little things and carryover and drills that you're doing in practice. They understand why. And they read screens really well, and there's just constant movement. And that's, if you're doing that to a defense, then the defense will, you know, they'll get switched up a little bit.
Yeah, and right now Delaware is just off kilter ever so slightly, which is hurting them. But then on top of it, the offensive end, they executed, I thought, pretty well the first three possessions. They were trying to attack inside. There was ball movement. They looked opposite. All of a sudden, the last couple of trips, quick shots, nobody in position to offensive rebound. And if you turn this into a jump shooting contest, it won't go Delaware's way.
No, and that's where, you know, the runs of the basketball game. Drexel has scored a few points in a row. You can't panic. You still have to, like you said, work the offense, and their spacing has not been as good as the first 3 minutes.
Joy Caracciolo checks in. Akima Richards sits down for UD. Erica Brown still running point. Also into the contest, Courtney Green, as Hannah Jardine grabs a seat for Delaware. Courtney Green with it, right wing, feeding up top Buchanan. Deep two, back rimmed it, went off the top of the backboard, out of bounds. It'll go back to Drexel. It's a deep shot for Buchanan. We've seen her make that this year, but again, early in the shot clock to pull the trigger on that shot.
And Matt, the referees have not called one single foul yet. We're 8 minutes into the game, and no fouls have been called, and that's good for Drexel, not good for Delaware.
Tori Fearoff checking in as well for the Dragons at the last whistle. She'll feed high post to Pearson, and Pearson throws it away. An interception by Brown. Brown tried to take it the other way. Out of control. Fires up a 15-footer. Almost got the roll. Offensive board. Buchanan had it. Curran came in, tied her up. And the arrow goes back to Drexel. Not sure about that decision there from Erica Brown.
Yeah, it needed another bounce. You needed another bounce, or you needed to pull up and wait, because they did not fill the passing lanes very well in transition. So if you don't have anything, it's okay to just back it out.
And a true freshman who's done much better at that lately, of knowing when to push, when to pull back. And she'll continue to learn. Fear off with it, far side of the floor for Drexel, feeding into the corner to Curran. Curran, left-hand dribble towards the wing, in some trouble, finding Jamila Thompson. Thompson at the foul line, left wing feed to Creighton. Creighton, left-hand dribble, handoff Pearson. Good double there by Delaware, forced the pass off to Creighton. Creighton on the drive, pass Brown. Brown fouled her with two on the shot clock as she tried to scoop one out. Good defense by Brown until the contact there at the end. And as a result, Megan Creighton going to head to the line to shoot two when we come back. Timeout on the floor, 11:44 left to go in the opening half. Drexel off to the early edge. They lead Delaware 15-8. You're listening to Blue Hens Basketball on 1290 The Ticket and 1410 WDOV.
Enjoy Blue Hens Basketball this season at the Bob with ticket specials, including youth group packages, the Slam Dunk Hoops and Scoops deal to enjoy U Dairy ice cream with Blue Hens basketball, game packs, and CAA mini plans to catch all the high-flying CAA basketball action at the Bob this winter. For more information, visit BlueHens.com today.
Hold on to me as we go. Just know you're not alone. 'Cause I'm gonna make this place yours.
WDOV.
11:44 left to go in the opening half. Tough start for the Hens. They trail Drexel by a score of 15-8. The stories of the early going. Sarah Curran scoring the first 10 points for the Dragons as Megan Creighton at the line left misses the first free throw. And since, it's been Rachel Pearson with 5 and a row for the Dragons. That's their 15 points as Creighton finally a third scorer on the board. She knocks down the second free throw. Drexel doubling up Delaware 16-8. Hens struggling on the offensive end.
And a rare miss there at the free throw line. Drexel, one of the best teams in the nation as a team with free throw shooting.
Buchanan off a nice feed from Courtney Green goes baseline for the reverse layup. And the Hens end the scoreless drought. It's 16-10 now.
And Delaware still in that man-to-man defense.
Left wing, Thieroff with it. Up top to Thompson. Head fake to three. Now dishes off right side to Pearson. Foul line right feed on a chest pass goes to Creighton. The point guard dribbles up top. Picks up for bounce in some trouble. Bounce feed left wing to Thieroff. Back to Creighton. Creighton left hand dribble with three to shoot. Dishes off. Curran for three. Front rim, but another offensive rebound by Pearson. But it's taken away. Long arms of Alicia Bell got in the pass lane and the steal. She outlets it up to Brown. Feeding left wing Green. Had an open three. Didn't pull the trigger. Instead, back to Brown. She will for three and it's good. Erica Brown on the two-man game with Courtney Green, and it's down to a three-point Drexel lead with 10:45 left first half.
And that all occurred because Courtney Green was able to create space for Courtney, or for Erica Brown, who was popping. A little two-man game there.
Impressive stuff by the Hens, able to get a secondary break opportunity. Now Curran the other way. She slowed down offensively. Thieroff gets it up top. Backdoor feed, a beautiful one to a cutting Rachel Pearson. And boy, has her game taken the step to the next level.
Absolutely, and that's the basketball IQ that this team has. They read screens so well.
Layup makes it 18-13. Delaware the other way now. Around the perimeter, Brown up top. Left wing feed to Green. Back to Brown, top of the circle to Green on the left wing. Feeding into the corner, Buchanan. Deep two is good. Kelsey Buchanan, movement without the ball, and nice ball movement there by the Hens.
And if she's able to consistently hit that shot in this game, there's really not a good matchup for Drexel against Kelsey Buchanan.
Drexel 18, Delaware 15, 9:50 to go, first half. With it, right wing Pearson. Up top, her feed goes to Thieroff. Thieroff back to Pearson, foul line right, triple, back rimmed it. Nice box out by Brown to grab the rebound. Here comes Erica Brown on the run the other way. Hens down three with the ball. Gives it to Courtney Green. Head fake to three on the left wing, driving in, and she was hand checked. And that is the first team foul on Drexel almost 10 and a half minutes into the game. The teams have combined for two fouls total.
And that's so interesting because there's been a lot of contact on some of these plays, and then they call a hand check. And I know that's a point of emphasis this year. If you have the open hand and you tap twice, they're going to call it. And nice sign there that Courtney Green was attacking with the bounce.
Here's an inbound up top to Green. Green near the right wing. Up top to Buchanan. Left wing dish goes to Bell. She'll drive baseline. Can't finish in tight. Tipping the offensive board was Buchanan, but it ends up in the hands of Pearson, who comes the other way. Pearson towards the right wing. Dishing off to Creighton. Creighton up top to Thieroff. Back in at the last whistle was Reddick. And also Fiona Flanagan, Reddick with it, top of the circle. Looking over options, feeding quarter to Creighton. Delaware's defense has really improved here the last few trips. Thieroff with it, left wing. Back door to Reddick. Let the defense clear with a head fake and then finish with a left hand. 20-15. Boy, did Abby Reddick get good in the offseason.
She sure did. And you know, sometimes when you're the senior leader, look at what Kelsey Buchanan has done, how she's emerged this year, similar for Abby Reddick for Drexel.
She looks like a different player. Mm-hmm. Inside feed goes to Buchanan. Double comes, looks opposite, left wing three. Courtney Green connects. What ball movement by the head.
And Delaware, that's what they need. They need that inside-out game. So if you have Kelsey Buchanan on the inside doing what she does best and you have Courtney Green hitting those threes, that's what Delaware needs because then you become a threat in a hard matchup.
Drexel lead down to two. Reddick to the foul line on the bounce, feeding left wing Thieroff. Fake to pass, now feeds up top to Pearson. Pearson over to Creighton, right wing. Up top to Reddick. Reddick, handoff goes to Creighton. Creighton, right wing to Flanagan. Five to shoot. Flanagan gets it inside Reddick. tried to seal. Caracciolo has to force up a jumper. Couldn't get the roll. Rebound grabbed by Courtney Green. Green to Brown. Looks back at her coach, says push it. So Erica does. Feeds corner to Buchanan near side. Looks opposite again. Left wing Green. Puts it on the deck. Drives inside. Draws the defense. Leads it off to Caracciolo, who finishes in tight. And we're tied at 20.
What a great job by Courtney Green. And actually, she was just calling to come out of the game again. She had no surgery this year for that broken nose, or this week. And she just gave the hand. She needs to come out.
Backdoor feed to Creighton. Creighton on the left block. Tries to dish it outside to Flanagan. Throws it away. Out of bounds. Back to Delaware. The Hens all of a sudden playing much better basketball. They have pulled even, 20 apiece. Timeout on the floor, 7:40 left. In the opening half, you're listening to University of Delaware women's basketball on 12-9 of the Ticket and 14-10 WDOV.
After a season of intense competition, only the elite are left standing.
Oh, wow.
The best in men's college lacrosse are coming to Newark, Delaware.
Let's it fly and score.
Experience it live at the 2014 NCAA Division I Men's Lacrosse Quarterfinals, Sunday, May 18th at Delaware Stadium in Newark, Delaware. Affordable tickets available.
And we are tied!
Visit ncaa.com/lacrosse and make a date with champions.
From day one, our mission has been March. Those 4 days in Baltimore are the reason for every rep, every sprint, every shot. Every time we step on the court, we dream of stepping on that ladder, cutting down those nets, raising that trophy. In the CAA Men's Basketball Championship, anything can happen. So turn up the music. It's time to dance.
For more information, visit caasports.com. Order tickets at ticketmaster.com.
Minutes, 40 seconds left to go in the opening half, and all of a sudden it's the Hens streaking in the right direction after trailing 16-8. They've gone on a 12-4 run to pull even at 20 apiece. Christine looking better offensively, but more important, very sharp on the defensive end.
Sharp with their activity, and they're not allowing extra chance, second chance points for Drexel. They are getting those rebounds, and that is key. Early on, they were not doing that.
Akima Richards back into the game, replacing Courtney Green. Delaware basketball moving left to right. Far corner with it is Kelsey Buchanan. Feeds right wing to Alicia Bell. Dishing over towards the corner. Richards hands it off to Buchanan. Baseline jumper, air ball deep. Rebound grabbed by Alexis Smith, who has missed the last couple of games with injury. But the freshman in the lineup today off the bench. Curran gets a feed from her. Back to Smith, top of the circle. She's the backup point guard. Feeding off to Flanagan, right wing. Down low to Curran. Head fake. Buchanan held her feet. Forced a feed into the corner to Smith. Smith bobbled it, but got it back. Brown all over her. Dishing right wing to Reddick. Backdoor feed tipped by Brown. Out of bounds. It'll stay with Drexel. But great recovery there defensively by Erica Brown.
And not only recovery, she did it the right way. She snapped her head, but she had her hand out. So even though she could not see the ball, when she saw her man going to the basket, she put that hand out.
Ball, you man, with a hand in the passing lane. Here, though, they can't get a hand in the passing lane. Curran flashing towards the middle, gets hit with a pass and lays it home with the right hand. She has 12 points. Drexel back up by two.
Boy, Sarah Curran's listed at 5'11", but she looks a lot bigger out there.
She does, and she can shoot the ball a little bit, plus put it on the deck. Bounce feed, left wing goes to Brown. Into the corner, Bell. Back up top to Brown. Brown high post to Buchanan. Looks opposite. Deep two, right side from Richards. Got a high bounce off the rim. It hit the tin again, but would not fall. Board grab by Smith. She brings it up the other way and slows it to Flanagan, who will set up the offense. Left wing feed to Reddick. Reddick over to Curran. Curran out of control this time and still scoops it up. It toilet bowls around but falls out. Unfriendly roll there for Curran, who's gotten every bounce so far. Brown the other way for Delaware, feeding off to Richards. Gets it to Caracciolo at the foul line, attacking off the dribble and drawing soft contact, but getting the foul call. A little bit of a bailout whistle there, but the Hens will take it for Joy Caracciolo.
Yeah, and this is where Delaware has to be a little cautious. You know, Drexel made a couple shots here, and, you know, if Joy can tie this game up, that's great. But if the biggest thing with this entire game is there's going to be runs, and if Drexel can score in a hurry, Delaware has to just chip away and fight back.
Caracciolo first free throw, front rim, left rim, and out. That has been a problem for Joy all season long. She is now sub 50% for the season for the foul line as Courtney Green returns, Akima Richards goes out.
Yeah, and she does such a great job drawing the fouls. You have to convert on the free throw line.
Second foul shot, she lets it go. Good rotation, and it hits nothing but net. She's going to take a seat. Shanice Johnson going to check back into the game. We'll see how Johnson responds. She had a tough first 3 or 4 minutes out there.
Yeah, and most of it was defensively. On the offensive end, you know, she got a couple early looks, but defensively, she's matched up right now with Reddick. And earlier, she couldn't guard Curran, but let's see how she does against Reddick.
Here's Flanagan, left wing with it for Drexel, with the Hens down by 1:50 to go first half. Right wing feed goes over to Pearson, couple dribbles towards the foul line, now over right wing Smith, fires up a three, back rimmed it, board on the weak side, grabbed by Alicia Bell, outlets it up to Brown, again looking to run, leaving it Courtney Green, thought about a three, didn't shoot it, instead up top Johnson, dribbling to the foul line and kicking out left wing to Bell. Top of the circle feed, Buchanan forced to pass inside to Johnson. It was tipped away, but right in the hands of Brown. She'll fire up a shot, wouldn't go. Air ball short. Offensive board, though. Johnson grabbed it. No reset of the shot clock. 8 to shoot. Brown with it, left wing. 5 on the timer. Sees it. Feeds to Bell. Extra pass into the corner. Green driving into traffic and walked. Courtney Green's got to pull the trigger on that right wing three.
Especially as the shot clock is winding down. She received the ball with under 3 seconds on the shot clock, and you're the shooter on the team. You gotta take it. Gotta take that shot.
That's something the coaching staff has been imploring her to do. She's such a good shooter. They just wanted to feel free to pull the trigger whenever the opportunity arises. Kerr, and nice cross-court feed. Quick release of a three by Flanagan. Would not go. And Green there to clean up on the glass.
Drexel was shooting close to 50% earlier in this game. Now it's creeping down. They're at 40% now.
Green, high post to Johnson. Hand off to Green, top of the circle. Right wing to Bell. Looking inside. Bounce pass off the leg of Buchanan. She got it back. Feeds out on the wing to Brown. Brown circling towards the top of the key. Left wing dish to Green. Driving baseline. Now floats it up. Too strong. Air ball deep. Got the rebound back and then got fouled. I'm not sure how Courtney Green did that. Houdini-like act, but Hens will take it. It'll be their ball as they call the foul on Sarah Curran, her first, team's third.
And remember, Courtney Green had surgery on her nose, and just you can tell she's just not feeling great. She's really trying hard out there, and she's really plugging away.
She is, and she is going amongst the trees right off the dribble. She's not scared of anything. Gets it off the inbound in the corner for three, rattled it out. Rebound grabbed by Pearson for Drexel. She's been active on the glass in the early going, her sixth board already. Smith in the forecourt with it for Drexel, feeding up top to Creighton. Looking backdoor, had Pearson, couldn't get her. Instead over to Curran, back right wing triple for Creighton, wouldn't go. And Green up top for the rebound, got tied up. No quick whistle, which we normally see in the women's game. And Green able to rip it free.
Lucky for Delaware, Drexel's gone on a little bit of a cooling streak here. Haven't made a lot of their outside shots in the last few possessions.
Baseline drive, Buchanan got position laid at home, plus a foul. Courtney Green got it off to Kelsey Buchanan, who slithered along the baseline, came back up near the 10, kissed it home, and will head to the line to try to extend the Delaware lead when we come back. Timeout of the floor, 3:59 left to go in the opening half. It's Delaware 23, Drexel 22. You're listening to University of Delaware Women's Basketball on 12-9 of the Ticket and 14-10 WDOV.
Delaware Athletics sponsors 21 teams comprised of over 600 student-athletes and will award nearly 230 scholarships costing $9.5 million this year. Blue Hen fans across the nation contribute to the University of Delaware Athletic Fund each year. Your contributions provide scholarships, equipment, and academic support so UD student-athletes can compete in the sport they love and receive a college education.
State of Mind on 1290 The Ticket and 1410 WDOV.
Kelsey Buchanan, who's coming off of a 24.11 rebound performance in her last game against UNC Wilmington, at the line here out of immediate timeout to shoot one free throw. Already 10 points. Buchanan has scored in double figures in all 16 of Delaware's games now on the season. She rattles out the free throw, a rare miss at the line for KBU, but the Hens up 23-22 with just under 4 minutes to go in the opening half.
And did we expect anything else from a Delaware-Drexel matchup?
Curran, left wing deep, too good again. Sarah Curran, 14 points in just over 16 minutes for the true freshman.
It's always been a freshman these last couple years, hasn't it been? It's always been a freshman hitting these threes against Delaware.
Pearson killed Delaware last year a couple of different times, and so far tonight it has been Curran. Here on the right wing, it's Green. Green feeding near corner Buchanan deep. Too good. Kelsey Buchanan about a 17-footer baseline right, and ends back up one, 25-24.
And she's doing it everywhere, inside the basket, putting the ball on the floor, and shooting the mid-range jump shot.
She's got an assortment of moves, kind of showing them off right now. Pretty much a lock to be a first-team All-CAA performer this year. Creighton with a top of the circle off a head fake. Got a defender in the air, drove inside, but nice rotation by the Delaware defense. But it leads to an open shot on the right wing, foot on the line for a two from Alexis Smith. And Drexel back up by a point.
And here we go. Drexel cooled off, missed a bunch of shots in a row. Now they've hit on two straight possessions.
Brown the other way for Delaware. On the wing to Buchanan. Near corner feed to Bell. Back up top to Johnson. Johnson looking left block. Buchanan out to Green. Left wing triple. Back rimmed it. Long rebound. Creighton able to chase it down.
And that's okay. That's great ball movement. It went around, inside out, and that's a great shot.
Your shooter with her feet squared wide open. You'll take that every time. Mm-hmm. Reddick with it. Right wing for Drexel. Surveying her options. Feeding up top to Creighton. 2:20 left first half. Hens down by one. Creighton right wing to Smith. Smith back to Creighton on the left side of the floor. Into the corner near side. Reddick try to drive baseline on Johnson. Out of control. Try to reverse layup and then foul Johnson on the rebound. Boy, Abby Reddick has shown off an assortment of moves she did not have a year ago, but she has been unable to finish in tight. That is her second foul, team's fifth. Only six fouls combined between the two teams, so obviously Reddick, the only player on either squad in foul trouble.
And we've talked so much this season about finishing well, finishing the half well. So now you have Reddick going out with two fouls. You have 2 minutes to go in the first half, and Delaware wants to do a good job with this possession and finishing out the half.
It's a mark of a good team. Good team, close out half strong. Brown with it, right wing for UD. Drexel's not been the same team defensively without Reddick. They feed up top to Johnson, and an armbar foul going to be called on Megan Creighton. So all the stuff they have let go, the one thing that they are going to continue to call is the nickel-dimer hand check.
And head coach for the Drexel, Denise Dillon, just called the ref over and said, look, it's 6-1, six fouls on Drexel and only one on Delaware.
Erica Brown looking to get it in, lobbed it to nobody except for a Drexel player, and Creighton took it away. Long outlet pass to Smith. Smith into Bell, and that's going to be a block, and that's a good call. The crowd does not like it, but Bell was not in position. And it just happened to be the same official that Denise Dillon called over to talk to, but that was a pretty obvious block that time.
And not only was she not in position as the Drexel player was, you know, coming into, she flopped. She was fading backwards, and you're never going to get that call.
She flopped into the contact.
Yeah, exactly.
That's a double whammy. First free throw for Smith as a result is good. Drexel as a team now 2 of 3 from the stripe for the game. As Jody Sawyer going to come back into the game for the first time in 2 weeks. She suffered a concussion here at the Carpenter Center against Hofstra. She was not cleared to play until a couple of days ago, even practice, as the second free throw rattles in and out. And good to see Sawyer back into the contest.
And they've really missed her because, you know, this tandem of Erica Brown and Jody Sawyer has worked very well. So really happy to see her back out on the floor.
Well, Jody now triggering the offense. Bounce pass feed right wing to Green. Up top to Johnson. Johnson, one dribble, now feeds left wing to Johnson. Sawyer. Sawyer up top to Green. Back to Sawyer, left wing. Looking in the corner, Alicia Bell will pull the trigger on a deep two. Back rimmed it, and Smith comes in to grab the board.
And since Abby Reddick has gone out, Drexel has actually increased their lead.
It went from a one-point game to a two-point game, but Delaware has not scored since she picked up that second foul. Left wing dribble, it's Creighton. Bounce pass feed, foul line left to Flanagan. Flanagan dribbles towards the top and dishes off to Smith, top of the circle. Smith with 10 to shoot, and we'll get a whistle away from the ball. And Shanice Johnson just bulldozed into Sarah Curran. No, they're going to call a moving screen on Curran. Wow, that's her second foul. Team 7, Johnson knocked Curran to her backside, but evidently Curran was not set when the contact came.
Well, that is a big break for Delaware. From my view, it looked like Shanice Johnson just bulldozed her over, but really great break for Delaware here. Now, with a minute to go, a good chance to get a really solid possession.
I think Denise Dillon had the same view as you. She's really giving it to the official far sideline. Hannah Jardine back into the game, gets it far corner. Tried to dish it in to Johnson, who dribbled it off her foot. It's taken away by Creighton. Here comes Megan Creighton the other way, feeding right corner to Leona Flanagan down low on the block. Smith will lay one home. And Drexel back up by four with 40 seconds to go in the half.
Drexel, just such an intelligent team. They really take on the personality of their head coach, Denise Dillon. Gritty and intelligent.
Sawyer into the corner to Green. Again, had an open shot, didn't pull the trigger. Feeds up top to Johnson, right wing to Jardine. Jardine, one bounce, feeding baseline Johnson. Head fake out the defender in the air, then left it off. Nice bounce pass to Buchanan, but a little too strong off the glass. And the rebound grabbed by Thiroff for Drexel. What a feed, though, by Johnson.
And it was that short corner and then into that little mid to low post area, and that's a shot Kelsey Buchanan usually makes.
Five left and a half. Creighton left wing working off a screen. Head fake now gives it to Thiroff. Thiroff in trouble. Passes and they won't get a shot off. Undrexel-like there to end the first half, but good defense by Delaware. They really clamped down over the final 15 minutes. Unfortunately for the Hens, the offense went quiet over the final four themselves.
Yeah, just a lot of one and dones. Not as good of a look. And, for Drexel, they should be feeling fantastic right now because picking up seven fouls to the two of Delaware and being up by four, if you're Drexel, they went cold for a while. So they're feeling pretty good. Delaware should be feeling pretty good as well because they didn't play the best half. They were great on defense, very active. But like you said, offensively, they need to pick some things up there.
Should be interesting to see the final 20 minutes. We'll take a timeout, send it back to Andrew Robertson in our Newcastle studios. He'll have your halftime report when we return at the break. It's Drexel 29, Delaware 25. You're listening to Blue Hens Basketball on 12-9 of the Ticket at 1410 WDOV.
A new year with the same great Blue Hens beat. We are back. I'm Scott Klaskin.
Happy New Year, all the Blue Hens fans out there. I'm Jimmy Smith. Great show coming up for you, and we're happy to be back.
Coming up, Meet the Hens is back as softball speedster Jessica Grizzler answers the tough questions, and basketball is into conference play. So how about an inside listen to head coach Monte Rolfe during the stressful CAA opener versus Hofstra?
And Scott will have your Blue Hens sports update, but before all of that, with the MLS Super Draft coming up on January 16th, we sit down and talk with head men's soccer coach Ian Hennessy and talk about the professional prospects for two of his senior standouts.
Prince has had a great season for us. He's part of the reason, along with Vinny, that we scored so many goals, because Prince's ability to come forward from a left fullback position is an important part of how we play. I think because he is a left-sided player, that Prince has the ability to be drafted. Because there's not that many quality left-sided players, at least from what we've seen this year. So I would not be surprised if he ends up in the professional ranks. Prince's strengths are his technical ability. He's wonderfully gifted on the ball. It's not a problem for him. Very strong physically. He's got all the attributes that it takes to be an MLS player. But at the next level, the professional level, it's not just about the technical ability. It's also the tactical ability, and that's where he really will have to step up his game, because at the next level, the speed and pace of things is so much quicker than the college game, and that's something I think he'll need a training camp and some years to figure out. Yeah, Vinny is for me one of the best passing midfielders in the country. His ability to strike a ball over different distances unparalleled, and I think will suit the MLS with the wide open kind of style of play that many of them do play, a very good brand of soccer. So from that perspective, I think his chances of going are good. If not in the draft, then at least to be invited in for training. Very gifted technically, sees the game well, works both sides of the ball, and I think he'll be a surprise pickup for many MLS teams, and as he was a surprise pickup for us, he really was a dark horse and was had a wonderful career here at the University of Delaware. Vinny's best position is in the middle of the field. His ability to hit targets from any area is really one of the strengths of his game, and it's not often you see in the MLS people with the quality of passing that he has. I wouldn't say it's Beckhamish, but he's up there. There's no question about that. He can strike a ball wonderfully over distance at ease. It's not a struggle for him at all. The thing that Vince has to learn the next level is also, again, just reading the play quicker. That you're not allowed the time that he'll see in the college ranks. You know, some games you're under the cosh and you have to make decisions that are game-changing decisions, and that happen over milliseconds. And that's something that I think he's able to do. But to do it on a consistent basis, that's the measure of a pro. We try to build our program around a strong spine. And Vinny certainly is part of that, and he is a huge loss for us. His training habits, his work ethic are second to none, and you know, positionally that becomes a gaping hole for us next year that we're going to look within the squad to fill, and also to bring someone from the outside as a freshman in to come in, and if he can do half as good a job as Vinny has done, then we'll be okay next year. Success leaves clues. And when you have the level of success, whether it's NCAA appearances or CAA championships, academic All-Americans, All-Americans, then I think it's probably an indication that you're on the right track. And for these guys, it just raises the profile of themselves, of the soccer program, and of the university. So we're absolutely, obviously thrilled that they were wonderful ambassadors and represent the university in the classroom and on the field as much as they have, and hopefully sets the bar higher now for the next guys coming in, that they too want to be All-American, they too want to turn pro and have the success that this senior class has shown over the last 4 years.
Hi, I'm Jessica Grizzler, junior outfielder on the Blue Hen softball team. One thing people might be surprised to know about me is I moved to Washington, D.C. from California. My favorite song to listen to before games is probably Fun, Some Nights. Or I usually put it on Pandora and just go from there. Other than softball, I enjoy shopping. That's pretty much my go-to. Or being with family. It's my favorite thing to do. My most memorable moment would probably be my freshman year, CAAs. We were playing JMU in the seventh inning. We were down by 4, and I hit a 2-run home run. My teammates are family. I don't even consider them teammates. We're, you know, 18 sisters out there.
Has anybody ever said you look like somebody?
I've gotten that I look like Taylor Swift before.
Really?
I don't see that since 5'2", and she's not. And I can't sing at all, so. If my life was on the line and I had to karaoke a song, I would probably bring it back to NSYNC, since I actually know all the words to that. Probably Bye Bye Bye. Everyone knows that, right? Bye Bye Bye. Do I need a dance move?
Can you? I mean, we
can. If I could trade lives with somebody, it would probably be Ricky Henderson, the Oakland A's baseball player. He's been my idol since I was little. You know, I'm an Oakland A's fan. Been to all the games. My trainer in California actually was his brother-in-law. Two things I can't live without is family, obviously, and I don't want to say it, but my cell phone. You knew that was coming. One word my teammates would use to describe me is probably childish, because I act like I'm 12 out there. I like to bring, you know, fun and light into every situation, but definitely am a 5-year-old little boy out there. So that's a little bit about me, junior outfielder Jessica Grizzler. Go Blue Hens.
It's time for our first sports update of the new year. So let's start in the pool as the 7 seniors of Delaware swimming and diving team shine as the Blue Hens defeated both Drexel and Northeastern on senior day. The class of 2014 accounted for 9 top finishes as the Blue Hen men defeated Drexel 165 to 140.5. The Delaware women topped Northeastern 163.5 to 136.5 and dominated Drexel 218 to 79. The Delaware men were led by Corey Camp and Alex Hillsley, who were the only Blue Hens to tally 2 first-place finishes. Alex Tooley, Tim Ware, Zach Lowe, and Colin Hall each earned 1 first-place finish. For the Blue Hen women, the 200 medley relay squad earned a first-place finish against both Drexel and Northeastern. The squad that earned a 145.69 finish consisted of Alyssa Sanders, Annie Noons, Caitlin Walla, and Morgan White. In the only other relay event of the meet, the Blue Hens also earned a first-place finish. The 400 freestyle relay team of Maggie Tracy, Mary Kay Harris, Dominique Montoya, and White finished the heat in 333.36. Delaware returns to CAA action Saturday, January 25th, when the Hens travel to Towson to take on the Tigers. The meet is set to begin at 1 p.m. On to the hardwood now, as Blue Hens men's basketball held off James Madison on the road 78-74, giving Blue Hen head coach Monte Ross his 100th career victory.
Delaware won its season best fourth straight game, improving to 10-7 overall and 2-0 in the CAA. Senior Devon Sadler led the Blue Hens with 25 points off the bench, while Davon Usher added 21 points and knocked down 5 three-pointers. Jarvis Threet tossed in 16 points, 6 rebounds, and 4 assists. Delaware will look for its fifth straight win on Wednesday when the Blue Hens host William & Mary at 7 p.m. Women's hoops now, where the trip to Harrisonburg didn't go quite as well. James Madison University stifled the Blue Hens 87-51 in the largest loss since 2008 for the Hens. The loss marks the first for Delaware in CAA regular season and tournament action since the 2010-11 season, when the Dukes defeated the Blue Hens 67-61 in the championship final of the CAA tournament. Freshman Erica Brown led Delaware with 12 points and a career-high 9 rebounds, in addition to 2 assists, as senior Kelsey Buchanan added 10 points and 8 rebounds. The Blue Hens return home for a matchup against the Seahawks of UNCW this Friday at 7 p.m. Get tickets for both men's and women's games on BlueHens.com or by calling 302-831-2257. Let's take a look at the upcoming schedule.
Delaware Athletic sponsors 21 teams comprised of over 600 student-athletes and will award nearly 230 scholarships costing $9.5 million this year. Blue Hen fans across the nation contribute to the University of Delaware Athletic Fund each year. Your contributions provide scholarships, equipment, and academic support so UD student-athletes can compete in the sport they love and receive a college education.
A season of intense competition, only the elite are left standing.
Oh, wow!
The best in men's college lacrosse are coming to Newark, Delaware.
Let's it fly and score!
Experience it live at the 2014 NCAA Division I Men's Lacrosse Quarterfinals, Sunday, May 18th at Delaware Stadium in Newark, Delaware. Affordable tickets available.
Denver, we are tied!
Visit ncaa.com/lacrosse and make a date with champions.
Welcome back to the show. With the all-important start to conference play for Delaware men's basketball, we thought it'd be fun to mic up head coach Monte Ross and hear what the game sounded like. Lucky for us, we got a good one as the Hens and Hofstra battled to the end. So here it is. Here's Coach Ross and what he had to say about it.
First thing we have to do is we have to make sure everybody, if we're going to take this journey, that we're all going the same direction. We all got to get there. Everybody has an important role. Everybody has an important role in this journey. We need everybody just to do their job. Everybody is equally important. Everybody's equally important. We need you to do your job, though. We need you to do your job. Your job has been clearly defined to you. We need you to do that. We don't need you to do more. We don't need you to do less. We need you to do your job. Now, what we need you to do is do your job at the highest level. We need every single guy to follow the plan. We'll look up and we'll be amazed at where we are.
How you doing, man?
How's
you
all right?
Happy New Year to you.
I'm good, man. Family good and everything?
Good. Good.
Hey, man. How you doing, man?
Good.
What's up, Bennett Alley?
What's up, Mike? Are you mic'd up tonight?
I'm mic'd up.
Let's
go, KA.
Let's
go, Jarmo. Everybody talks. Watch. It's intimidating when we talk, fellas. It's intimidating. Let's be intimidating out there with our talk. Hey, let's establish ourselves right away and let them know what this thing is going to be about for 40 minutes. All right? Let's go. Together on three. One, two, three. Let's go now. Yeah! Oh! Hey! 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 Talk, guys. We got to talk. We got to talk.
You're here, Ash.
Marvin. Hey, box out here, box out.
Come on, y'all.
They didn't earn anything.
We ain't playing no defense, guys, because we're not talking. We got to communicate on defense, all right? Us. All right, we got to climb our way back out of this. We got to climb our way out. We got to get some stops down here. All right. Oh, it's a foul! Go, go! And one! Now back, now back, now back! Fox! Come on, talk, 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 talk! All right, Mo, go. No, he went like that, Clarence! Missed that one. No. No, 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 why? He swung like that. Can't miss that one. Come on, Clarence, come on. Power, 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 power. All right, we got to get it right here. Hey, come on, guys. Be smart. Let's finish the game out. Come on. Good job.
We got what we came to get. We're 1-0 in the league. You cannot get to 2-0 if you don't get to 1-0. So I'm proud of you. Congratulations for the win. Together on three. One, two, three.
Together. Coaching, it is a stressful profession, but the Hens, with great poise and a great effort to beat Hofstra, open up CAA play 1-0, win their fourth straight CAA conference opener. Big thanks to head coach Monte Ross for letting us listen what it takes to be a coach on those Delaware sidelines. And a big thank you to everyone who brought this show together, and a big thank you to everyone watching at home. For Jimmy Smith, I'm Scott Klatskin, and as always, go Hens.
From getting those offensive rebounds, but Delaware has to get some of those putbacks. And when they did, you know, you're not going to make every shot, but you need to give yourself opportunities to increase the amount of possessions that you get.
Delaware ball to start this second half. Shanice Johnson with it, left wing, forced to pass inside. It got tipped twice, ends up off the hands of Kelsey Buchanan, out of bounds. Not the start to the half Delaware had in mind.
No, and as a coach, that those are the little things that just kill you, because you have the whole halftime to talk. You come out, you want to have a good first possession, and you have a turnover. But nice leadership by Kelsey Buchanan, pulling the freshman Shanice Johnson over and trying to help coach her up on the floor a little bit.
Poor Janine Rodis hadn't even sat down, going back across the floor from our interview, and the Hens had already turned it over. Reddick with it, high post for Drexel, feeding outside to Creighton. Creighton right hand dribbled towards the wing. Dishes off to Curran, foul line right. Curran, cross court feed left wing to Flanagan. Flanagan hand check call against Jardine. And I have a sneaky suspicion we will see a lot of fouls early in this second half.
And especially a few on Delaware. I'm sure Denise Dillon talked to these referees about the foul differential of 7 for Drexel and only 2 for Delaware. And we hadn't seen that call for the majority of the game.
Here's the inbound to Creighton into the corner. Curran, front rim to jump shot. Good contest there by Shanice Johnson. Long rebound, Richards. Richards racing it the other way, going all the way to the 10, scooping it up. Too strong off the window, a little out of control. And the rebound tipped out of bounds by Johnson. Back to Drexel as Alicia Bell going to come in. Shanice Johnson going to go out.
I like the aggressiveness by Akima Richards, but when you're 1-on-4, you kind of need to pull that one back out. I do like that she's attacking, but if you see 1-on-4, you have to wait for your teammates there. You want, especially the last possession was a turnover. Understand you want to start this half off well, but Akima Richards continuing to attack on the offensive end.
Drexel 29, Delaware 25. Dragons with the ball. Flanagan feeds left wing to Curran. Curran had 14 in the first half, including 10 to start the game for Drexel. Up top to Flanagan, right wing to Abby Reddick. Reddick feeding to Creighton, top of the circle. Left wing Curran, far corner to Flanagan. Up top, Pearson off his screen for 3. Good. Brought rain. That one went so high into the air, but knocked it down. It's 32-25.
You know, whenever they're not playing Delaware, it is very pretty to watch Drexel play, the way they get those shots off and run each other off those screens.
Never seem to panic as the shot clock winds down. Up top, Brown. Right wing to Richards for Delaware. Minute and a half into the second half. Hens still looking for their first points. Brown will fire a 3. Front rim, back rim, and out. Jardine hustling on the offensive glass. Pulling down the rebound. Resetting it outside to Brown.
Hannah Jardine quickly becoming a crowd favorite here at the Bob Carpenter Center.
The give goes to Buchanan. Buchanan attacking off the dribble towards the foul line. And there's another hand check foul. This one called against Drexel. And is that on Reddick? If it is, it's her third. It is. So Abby Reddick picking up a third foul, and that's a story to keep an eye on.
And Reddick and Denise Dillon just kind of did a little, you know, nonverbal communication there, basically saying, I'm good, I can do it.
Inbound goes to Buchanan, back into the far corner to Green. Up top, her feet goes to Brown. Left wing dish to Richards. Richards, two dribbles towards the basket, then peels out. Dishes over to Brown, right wing. Brown getting a high screen from Jardine, using it. Dishing off to Richards, into the corner. Green, open triple. Back rim, no. Followed her shot, got it back. Great feed to Jardine on the opposite block, and she'll lay it home. There it was. Courtney Green finally follows her shot and gets a big offensive board, and then a beautiful pass afterwards.
The Bob Carpenter Center faithful, they love effort here. Again, one of the reasons why some of these young players are becoming favorites.
Flanagan for three the other way. Couldn't answer. Rebound Green. Green outlets it to Richards, who bites the deck and hits the ground hard. Hopefully she's all right. Not sure what she tripped over there. She gets up a little slow but hustles back. Wincing in pain as Drexel comes with it the other way. Flanagan inside, Reddick turnaround jumper on Brown. Couldn't get the roll, and Buchanan grabs the rebound. And it looks like Richards is going to try to gut through it. Brown brings it the other way. Hand off Green. Back to Brown. Corner triple. Back rim, no. Richards the offensive board. She wants to attack. Nothing there. Outside to Jardine. Dribble towards the foul line. Left wing dish to Brown. Out to Green for a reset.
And they missed Courtney Green. She was wide open. They missed her.
Right wing dish to Richards. Richards with a left-hand dribble into the lane, floats it home. How about that? Akima Richards clearly bothered. It looked like she landed awkwardly on her side when she fell down last time, but gets an answer, and the Hens back to within three.
Yeah, her side and her elbow, and that's not a fun thing to take the absorption of the fall as your elbow.
And is she a tough kid? Reddick diving towards the basket. Creighton missed her. Now circles towards the wing and feeds a bounce pass. Left side dish goes over to Curran. Curran with eight to shoot. Into the corner, Flanagan. And a whistle and a foul away from the ball. Going to be called on Delaware. They'll give it to Courtney Green for the hold. That was not a foul in the first half, but it appears as though it will be in the second half, so the players have to adjust. Reddick goes out, Smith back in for Drexel.
And as a former player, these are the things that drive you crazy, because you call it one way, and then, yeah, they have to adjust, but it's hard to adjust. You adjust for 20 minutes one way.
Quick inbound to Curran. She missed the jumper. Rebound grabbed by Brown for Delaware. You're right. That's hard to ask a player to adjust on the fly. Brown dribbling left wing, feeding up top to Jardine. Right wing dish goes over to Richards. Richards between the legs with a bounce, picks up her dribble, feeds baseline right. Jardine head fake, step back, jumper good. How about that move by the true freshman? And it's 32-31, six straight by the Hens, back to within a single point.
Hannah Jardine just always seems to find a way. You know, she creates space, she moves well without the ball. So glad to see her shots falling.
Hens crowd trying to get involved for the first time. Green gambles, doesn't get the pass, opens up Flanagan, who can't hit. Misses the corner three. Jardine another rebound. Outlets it to Brown. Here come the Hens racing the other way again. Hand off Green. Thought about a three, changes her mind. Tina Martin yells at her to shoot the ball, but the Hens will restart the offense.
One of these days, we will see Courtney Green shoot it every time.
There's one near corner three. Green missed it back rim, but you'll take that shot every time. And then Richards tipped the rebound out of bounds off of Pearson. It'll stay with Delaware when we return. The energy out of the locker room is fierce from the Hens. They're hitting the offensive glass, and as a result, they've turned a seven-point deficit into a one-point game. They trail 32-31, 15-22 left to go in the second half. You're listening to Blue Hens Women's Basketball on 12-9 of the Ticket and 14-10 WDOV.
With healthcare.
Drexel 32, Delaware 31. The Hens already 4 offensive rebounds in just over 4 minutes of the second half.
And that's been the key. Those second chance points, those extra possessions that you give yourself when you can get offensive rebounds. And now the Hens out-rebounding Drexel 25-19.
And it's Delaware ball here out of the media timeout. They float an inbound top of the circle to Courtney Green. Back to the inbounder near corner, Erica Brown. She'll circle towards the top to set the offense up. Tina Martin calls out a play from the bench. Delaware going right to left of the second half. Richards left wing up top to Jardine. Foul line right feed goes to Green. Green top of the circle to Buchanan. Back to Green with a chest pass. Forces an entry to Jardine. And they're going to call a foul or a kick ball. It'll be a foul, a hold there against Drexel. Official signaled 1-5. I don't think there is a 1-5. They still have not put who the foul is on the board.
There's nobody with
a 1-5. Oh, I beg your pardon.
Number.
It was a kickball. They set the shot clock to 15. Mm-hmm. So it looked like she was signaling a foul, but it'll just be Delaware ball up top to Courtney Green. Left wing dribble, dishes over to Richards. Richards driving towards the foul line, floating up a 14-footer, front rimmed it. It's batted around on the rebound attempt. Buchanan sprawling in, but couldn't get it. And it's pulled down by Jackie Sleuth for Drexel.
That's a great shot by Akeem Richards, though, elevating above the defense.
Here comes Sleuth the other way, out of control, missed the jumper, rebound out of bounds to Delaware.
Yeah, Delaware doing a great job in transition there, picking up those players. Sometimes in transition defense, you're going to have to just pick up the closest player, and it's all about communication, and Delaware doing a very good job there.
14:30 left, second half. Good game, as usual, between these two teams. Drexel and Delaware, the Dragons up by a point. Delaware with the ball. Green, left wing for three. Back rim, that one was right on. But again, she follows her shot, pulls down the offensive board, attacks towards the tin, and then got her shot blocked out of bounds. It'll stay with Delaware, 27 to shoot. They'll have the baseline left inbounds as returning into the game. Here's a number 15, Carrie Alexander playing for the first time. Megan Creighton checking out.
And another offensive rebound creates another offensive possession for Delaware.
Here's Brown on the inbound, floating corner to Green, far side of the floor. Up top to Brown, left wing to Richards, deep to good. Akima Richards off the ball, reversal, ready to shoot. And connects with 14 minutes to go. The Hens back up a point.
And Akeema Richards picking up where she left off in the last game and just attacking offensively with that mid-range jump shot.
Alexander with it for the Dragons offensively for the first time. Feeding up top to Flanagan. To Smith, back to Flanagan, right wing, trying to drive baseline. Jardine there defensively, forces a kick out to Alexander, 10 to shoot. She'll drive on Brown. Brown holds her ground, forces a tough shot, but Alexander hits with the left hand. Not bad for somebody who didn't play the entire first half.
And that's just a great offensive shot. I mean, Erica Brown did everything right defensively there. Maybe she let her get a little too low, but that's good defense.
Green, left wing, up top Jardine, head fake to three, back to Green, open triple. Not Courtney Green's day. She right rimmed it. Well, I think you want her to keep pulling the trigger, though, on those open looks.
The next one. It's always the next one. You always think the next one's going in.
Alexander up top to Smith for three. Can't get it to go. Nice rebound by Flanagan. They're going to call over the back on Flanagan. Boy, oh, boy, that's a tough call. Jardine had the box out. The Carpenter Center just now figuring out they called that foul against Drexel. You'll take it if you're the Hens, but seemed like just a pretty good play there by Fiona Flanagan.
Yeah, I would not have called that an over the back. If anything, Hannah actually had her arms wrapped around her. If you're allowed to stand behind a player and get a rebound. Not a great call, but it's good for Delaware.
Here come the Hens the other way. Foul line right, Richards. Up top, Jardine. Back to Richards. Lob entry. Great catch, Buchanan. Found contact. And will head to the line as a result to shoot two. What a tough catch that was on the right block for Kelsey Buchanan.
And sometimes people don't realize the importance of those entry feeds. It's communication. It's understanding when to deliver the basketball and delivering it in the right spot. And that was perfect for Kelsey Buchanan with the slip and the dive. And that's why she was able to get that shot off.
Buchanan back rim the first free throw. She'll get one more. That was the second foul on Rachel Pearson. Fiona Flanagan is going to check out of the contest, replacing her Sarah Kern, who was the leading scorer for Drexel in the opening half. The true freshman had 14 points, although she did miss 5 of her last 6 shots from the field. Buchanan rattles home the second free throw, and we're tied again at 34.
And again, this is what we expected, and it's good basketball, and it's just a really good college basketball game.
That's what Drexel and Delaware seem to deliver every time. Kern giving it off right side, forcing one up. Alexander couldn't get the roll. Rebound Buchanan. Outlet to Brown. Maybe got away with a little bit of a palm there, but feeds off to Green. Up top, Buchanan deep. 2 is good. Kelsey Buchanan trailing the play. foot on the line. Two Hens by two.
And that's something that has paid off for Kelsey Buchanan. All the work she put in this summer to be able to pull out and take those 15-foot jump shots, paying off now for the senior.
Alexander bumped by Richard Snowcall. Lost it out of bounds, they'll say, off of Akima. So it'll stay with the Dragons. Checking out Alexis Smith. Back into the contest comes the point guard, Megan Creighton. Creighton will trigger the inbound. Near sideline to us. Drexel moving left to right from our perspective. Inbound goes up top to Curran. Step back jumper. Missed the rim. Long rebound. Richards tipped it, and Curran falls to the ground to get it. And then Green fouls her. Tough bounce there for Delaware. And a good hustle play by the freshman Curran.
And that's where some of that carryover of drills and practice pickups. There's a drill that every basketball player hates. It's called pickups. And when you're picking up a loose ball, you don't want to try to dribble it up. You need to pick it up and then put it on the floor.
It's like football on a basketball court, right? That drill. Up top to Curran. Curran right hand bounce. Driving inside on Jardine. Tough finish. Boy, the freshman's got some offensive skill.
She's been fantastic today. She's been one of the best players on the floor.
Right block, Banker, and it's 36 apiece. Brown the other way for Delaware, up top to Jardine. Around the perimeter, left wing dish to Green. Up top to Buchanan, back to Green. Baseline jumper for Jardine, couldn't hit it. Nice pass by Green, good quick release, but shot wouldn't go. Alexander grabs the rebound for Drexel. Here comes Kerry Alexander, dribbling left to right, feeding left wing to Pearson. Pearson cross-court feed to Alexander, spinning into the lane and hitting. Where was she in the first half? Two nice moves, Dragons by two.
And sometimes you never know. Sometimes it's matchup. Sometimes it's she's coming back from a little something, hasn't practiced much, but what a great play.
Richards, left wing, feeding off to Green, left side of the floor, up top, back to Akima. Akima, left hand bounce into a double team, thought she got bumped, no call, airballed the jumper as a result. Creighton the rebound. Here comes Megan Creighton the other way and put two hands on the ball as she kind of bobbled it. Denise Dillon didn't like the call, but I think that was a good one. And the ball will head back to Delaware when we return. Timeout on the floor, 10:59 to go in the second half. Neither coach all that happy with the officials. The Hens trailing Drexel by two. You're listening to Delaware Basketball on 12-9 of the Ticket at 1410 WDOV.
Enjoy Blue Hens basketball this season at the Bob with ticket specials, including youth group packages, the Slam Dunk Hoops and Scoops deal to enjoy U Dairy ice cream with Blue Hens basketball, game packs, and CAA mini plans to catch all the high-flying CAA basketball action at the Bob this winter. For more information, visit BlueHens.com today.
Hold on to me as we go. Just know you're not alone, 'cause I'm gonna make this place your home.
WDOV. 10 minutes, 59 seconds left to go in the second half. Drexel 38, Delaware 36. We've already seen as many calls or fouls called in the second half as we did the entire first half. They're evenly distributed, though, three on each team. At an immediate timeout, it's going to be Delaware ball. Christine, looking at the numbers right now, what stands out to you?
It has been a very clean basketball game. Both teams doing well with assist-to-turnover ratio. Drexel 12-5 and Delaware 10-7. Delaware, five offensive rebounds this half.
Hens operating on the offensive end. A near turnover. Pass went off the hands of Jardine. Brown ran it down, gave it back to Hannah. 18-footer wouldn't go. Another offensive board. Green kicking it out. Brown, left wing three. Got it! What work on the offensive glass, and Delaware is back up by one.
Make that six offensive rebounds, and you're increasing your possessions, you're increasing your second chance points, you're giving yourself an opportunity.
Well done there by the Hens, 39-38, Delaware on top, 10:25 left. Curran tries and answer it, deep two is good. Jardine playing a hair off of her, can't do that today.
Just a fantastic day for the freshman Curran. She has been pretty much unstoppable.
Get in her grill, do not let her get a shot off without without at least working for it. Green now, left wing, feeding into the corner. Buchanan bumped by Schluth, no call, kicked it out. Brown straight away, three, back rim. And this time the rebound grabbed by Creighton, one and done for the Hens.
I think Erica thought she had that one, and I think the whole Bob was ready to erupt for that.
That was a heat check by the point guard, but a good shot off a nice pass. Here's a right wing feed to Creighton. Creighton head fake to three. Brown on her, picked up her bounce, feeds to Curran, top of the circle, lobs it inside to Schluth, and she's bumped by Buchanan. And that was Denise Dillon begging for that call and getting it on the sideline. Nice work on the officials.
That's a good call, though. She did. She had an open hand. She was riding her up, and that's a good call. You got to do the arm bar. You got to have an arm bar.
I think we've seen that pretty consistently and them not call it, though. Mm-hmm. Denise Dillon's been begging for it. Curran on the inbound hands it back to Creighton. Corner three. Good. You can't leave the inbounder against this Drexel team. Creighton makes Delaware pay.
And that's what we call America's play. That is the oldest out-of-bounds play in the book, and every high school, middle school, and CYO team run it. Got to be ready for that.
We've seen the Hens victimized by it a few times this year. Bell on the wing, feeding up top to Buchanan. Right wing dish to Brown. Brown calling for Green to come get it. Hands it off to her. Courtney with 10 on the timer, dribbling towards the top of the key. Now left wing dish, Bell into the corner. Brown, near side jumper, good. Erica Brown, big shots here in the second half. Hens back to within a point, 9:05 to go.
And that's great movement without the basketball, but a good job by Courtney Green to bring the ball over to Alicia Bell, and then Erica as the runner, one more great shot.
Under nine left, near side corner, it's Curran dribbling towards the foul line, angling one up, back rim, no, and Buchanan cleaning up the glass. Outlets it to Brown on the run. No numbers. She'll attack. Now hand back to Green. Green circles towards the wing. Gives it to Hannah Jardine. Feeding into the corner. Bell. Bell needs to reset. Does to Green. Outside to Brown, who calls out the set.
Drexel feeling good about the zone right now. They were doing made and misses, but now they're doing zone every time.
Inside to Buchanan. Back out to Brown. Dribble, attack, move, floater up. Front rimmed it. Rebound Pearson in traffic. Good board for Drexel.
And that's a shot we've seen Erica Brown hit a lot. Just needed a little bit more on the floater.
Pearson to her high school teammate Creighton. Creighton goes to Reddick. Reddick on a switch. Was left alone but can't finish inside. Rebound Buchanan. Outlet to Brown. Three on three. Brown goes herself. Misses off the window. Buchanan attacks the offensive glass. Tips it to Green. Giving it to Bell. Collides with Green. Then hit the bottom of the rim with a pass. And it goes back to Drexel.
Oh, that was not pretty. And Abby Reddick, you know, has a peak performance with her triple-double. Cannot buy a basket here today.
Nah, and she has made some nice moves, everything but the finish.
Just cannot finish, shooting one for nine.
42-41 Drexel. 7:40 left to go. Second half, Dragons with the ball. Creighton high post to Reddick. Reddick turn and face, attacking on Buchanan. Soft contact, and they call a foul on Kelsey Buchanan, who said, I went straight up, but some body contact will send Abby Reddick to the line when we return. Timeout on the floor, 7:34 left. It's Drexel 42, Delaware 41. You're listening to Blue Hens Women's Basketball on 1290 The Ticket and 1410 WDOV.
A season of intense competition. Only the elite are left standing.
Oh, wow.
The best in men's college lacrosse are coming to Newark, Delaware.
Let's it fly and score.
Experience it live at the 2014 NCAA Division I Men's Lacrosse Quarterfinals. Sunday, May 18th at Delaware Stadium in Newark, Delaware. Affordable tickets available.
Denver, we are tied.
Visit NCAA.com/lacrosse and make a date with champions.
From day one, our mission has been March. Those 4 days in Baltimore are the reason for every rep, every sprint, every shot. Every time we step on the court, we dream of stepping on that ladder, cutting down those nets, raising that trophy. In the CAA Men's Basketball Championship, anything can happen. So turn up the music. It's time to dance.
For more information, visit caasports.com. Order tickets at ticketmaster.com.
.34 seconds remaining in the second half. Drexel leading Delaware by a score of 42-41. University of Delaware women's basketball on 12 Night of the Ticket and 1410 WDOV, brought to you by the Glasgow Medical Aid Units, servicing the local community for over 20 years. When you need help, Glasgow Medical Aid Units are the place to turn. Also brought to you by Legacy Pharmacy, providing athletic rub-ins for where it hurts. Hens down one, 7:34 to go. Abby Reddick at the line to shoot two out of the media timeout. Boy, has this one been a slugfest or what?
It's just been a great basketball game. It's been fun to watch. It's been clean, not a lot of turnovers. Little bit of a difference in the way the fouls are being called as Abby Reddick hits her first, you know, from the first half to the second half. But the players have seemed to adjust. And now, you know, the Blue Hens with five fouls and the Drexel Dragons with only three.
Reddick, one out of two for the line for the 71% free throw shooter. So it stays a two-point game. And here's Jody Sawyer in the game for the first time in the second half, running point, feeding wing near side, Green to Buchanan in the corner. Looks opposite, right wing to Richards. High post feed to Johnson, attacking on the dribble. Line drive shot hit the bat or front rim, and the rebound grabbed by Reddick for Drexel.
And that's where you need one more bounce. You have to know where you are on the floor before. And if you don't have it, it's okay to kick it back out. And she'll learn that as she gets a little bit older.
Unfortunately, bad time to try to learn the lesson, although she tries to make up for it, but got a piece of Curran on a backdoor cut. Was hoping to trail the play and block the shot. Instead, called for the foul. And Sarah Curran, the 5'11 freshman out of Media PA, part of that triumphant of high schoolers at Carroll High that are on this Drexel team. Her, Megan Creighton, and Rachel Pearson won two state championships at the line and missing the first free throw.
And, you know, Drexel and Villanova both, and actually the entire Big Five really recruits very heavily in the Philadelphia Catholic League. And these players, they kind of know this system, and they've been going to these games since they were little kids.
Three Catholic League titles, two state championships, that's pretty good work. As Curran able to knock down one of two, she's done good work today in her own right. 19 points for the true freshman. Sawyer attacking the other way, leaving it off for Green. Back to Jody. Steps into a deep two. Front rimmed it. Rebound batted around. Out of bounds. Last touch by Drexel. It'll stay with Delaware.
And Jody Sawyer looking a little hesitant out there with her shot. She's only had one day of practice. And actually, they only walked through yesterday. They didn't go full speed because they only had one day in between games. So, you know, she's been out 2 weeks with a concussion.
And now she'll have some time between now and the next game to be eased back into the rotation. Inbound goes to Green up top, leaving it left wing. Brown missed the three. Missed it bad off the left rim. And then Buchanan, silly foul in the backcourt. And that's Delaware's seventh. So we will walk the length. And it'll be free throws coming here for 6'1 redshirt sophomore Jackie Sluth. Sluth has not played many minutes today, nor on the season, but she's 5 of 8 from the line on the year.
And this becomes critical because Drexel is a fantastic free throw shooting team. They're shooting almost 75% as a team, and they don't miss their free throws very often. So as she hits the first one. So now, you know, it's a four-point game. If you're going to be giving them those free opportunities, you know, you have to have really solid offensive possessions.
Sluth will get one more here. Second foul shot is good. It rattled home. Awkward release there. Very stiff-looking free throw, but she knocks down a pair, and now the Drexel lead is 5, and this feels like a big trip for UD.
Yeah, and Delaware's nowhere near the 1-1, so they need to have good possessions.
Jardine up top to Green, left wing dish to Brown. High post entry goes to Buchanan, turn and face, bounce past Jardine on a high low, and she is fouled. A lot of contact there, awkward looking fall. Hannah up though right away, she seems to be all right. Will that be on the floor or in the act? They're going to give her two shots, even though she never really left her feet.
See, I thought she was showing and going. She was doing a show and go move. She was trying to do the shot fake and swing the ball through to put it on the floor. But, you know, another break for Delaware.
And I thought the contact came after she had moved towards putting it on the floor, although Hannah missing the first free throw. It has been a struggle for her at the line this year, just 3 of 11 now on the season at the stripe.
And it's completely mental because she is a fantastic free throw shooter.
Indeed she is. Second foul shot here for the freshman. Back rimmed it. Big misses here, though. And the rebound grabbed by Drexel's Carey Alexander.
And that's the difference. If Drexel's going to hit their free throws, you have to make yours and convert.
Dragons by 5 with the ball. 6.25 minutes left to go. Hens got to dig in defensively. Curran, who has just called for a third foul, feeding corner. Sluth hits a deep two. Jackie Sluth coming up big. And it's a 7-point Drexel lead.
And the Bob Carpenter faithful just kind of seem a little deflated right now. They need to encourage this team. They need to get behind the team, and we need to start hearing them a little bit.
Here's Green, left wing, thought about a three. Instead, dishes off to Brown. Back to Green. Gives it to Brown, right wing. Into the corner, far side, Richards. Off the bounce, deep two is good. Akima Richards, that 17-footer's been there all night.
Yeah, she was our player of the game on Friday night against UNC Wilmington and picking up where she left off. But this is a critical point in the game before that next media timeout. They need to get a stop here.
Here comes Drexel in the forecourt. Creighton on the bounce. Bounce feed goes to Flanagan. They try to go backdoor. Richards was there defensively. Dishing off to Curran, right wing. Left wing dish goes to Alexander. Spinning on Richards. She stays in front, but out to Creighton. Open three. Good. Green was a little late getting out, and Megan Creighton made her pay.
If there is an Achilles heel to this Delaware team this year, unfortunately, it has been closing out on shooters at the three-point line.
And it's an eight-point Drexel lead, a timeout. Delaware, we will take it with the Hens. 5 minutes, 10 seconds left to go in the second half. Drexel 51, Delaware 43. You're listening to Blue Hens Basketball on 12-9 of the Ticket and 14-10 WDOV.
Delaware Athletics sponsors 21 teams comprised of over 600 student-athletes and will award nearly 230 scholarships costing $9.5 million this year. Blue Hen fans across the nation contribute to the University of Delaware Athletic Fund each year. Your contributions provide scholarships, equipment, and academic support so UD student-athletes can compete in the sport they love and receive a college education.
WDOV.
5 minutes, 10 seconds left in the second half. Critical possession here for Delaware out of their called timeout. It's 10 basketball, but down by 8. Erica Brown dribbling forecourt for UD, handing it off to Courtney Green. Perimeter pressure from Drexel. They give it off to Buchanan. Her pass tipped outside to Richards. Richards feeding into the corner to Joy Caracciolo, and she's fouled by Schluth. A bounce pass. Luth tried to go over the top to reach in and is called for her first personal and the team's fifth.
And that's crucial because they want to be in the one-on-one pretty soon. And, you know, this is Drexel's largest lead, 8, since the 11:44 mark.
4:56 left to go. Lob inbound goes on the elbow to Buchanan. Steps through a double team and floats one up and in. Front rim, but got the roll. And it's down to a 6-point game.
Defensive stops. You have to understand how to play your man with your trailing and your third man against these screens.
Creighton, right wing, dribbling against Brown, feeding up top to Curran. Curran, right-hand dribble, picks up her bounce. Left side, Alexander. Got it stripped by Green. Green running the other way. One on two. Green threw it away off the hands of Richards. Oh, my. Not sure why she didn't go up with it or circle it outside. Tried to force a feed, and that's a big turnover for Delaware. Great strip, though, by Green, and now a timeout as Creighton got doubled by Brown outside as she jumped out for a trap with Caracciolo. Good timeout by Drexel. They still have three left, but Courtney Green on the move came so close to getting the Hens back in it. We'll take this timeout with Drexel. 4:15 to go, second half. It's the Dragons 51, Delaware 45. You're listening to Blue Hens Basketball on 12-9 of the Ticket and 14-10 WDOV.
And 14-10 WDOV.
4 1/4 minutes left of the second half here from Newark. Drexel 51, Delaware 45. Drexel with the basketball out of their called timeout, 20 to shoot. Hens needing to dig in and put together some stops here down the stretch. Creighton left wing with a bounce for the Dragons. Looking for some help, feeding up top Curran. Driving on Buchanan, she stops her, forces an awkward hook shot that comes up short, an air ball. Grabbed by Richards, here comes Akima, on the run the other way. Hesitation move, out to Green, left wing three, got it! Courtney Green hits the triple, Hens within three, 3:50 to go.
We were just talking about clutch off the air, that is clutch. Courtney Green stepping into that three with confidence and cutting this lead to three.
A shooter's mentality, she's been off today, but keeps pulling the trigger. Now a trap leads to a steal, it's taken away, Buchanan. Got it, outletted it to Brown. Brown splits a double team, floats it up out of control and hit the front rim. Rebound grabbed by Drexel. She was trying to draw a charge or a foul there and probably should have just dished it off.
Well, and either you're going to you got to commit and go up for that layup or you're going to stay out and shoot the floater. You can't. It was kind of in between.
Redick top of the circle going back door. Nobody home. Throw it away. Turnover gives it back to Delaware.
And Denise Dillon kind of laughing over there, you know, knew what they were trying to do. Just a miscommunication there. The play was there, but she didn't see it.
How does this happen every time Delaware plays Drexel? You can skip the first 35 minutes. You know it's going to be a one possession game late. Here's Buchanan off the bounce, fired one up, short, air ball, out of bounds to Drexel.
And both teams right now with a couple possessions here that the coaches are not very fond of. So you want to use a little bit of the shot clock. Again, Drexel's in control. They want to use as much as they can, but Delaware needs to work the ball, not use the first option every single time.
52-48, Hens down by 4, 2:50 left. Redick top of the circle for Drexel. Again, look back door. This time didn't pull the trigger. Feeds to Curran, back to Redick. Deep two, she's been off today, but hits that one. Big shot by the fifth-year senior, and it's 54-48.
Again, Abby Redick coming off of the first triple-double in Drexel school history, and she's now makes it when it counts.
A quite upset Tina Martin calling for a timeout, bringing her team over, knowing the importance of this possession now. Down by six with 2:35 to go as the Bob falls eerily quiet here. Still a game, a two-possession contest with still more than 2:35 to go. But the Hens got to find a way to score on this possession because Drexel, good foul shooters across the board. It's going to be tough to play the catch-up game in the final minute.
And Delaware's still not yet in the 1-1. So even if they are able to draw a foul, they're not getting to the line unless it's in the act of shooting. And what Tina Martin is doing right now, she's drawing up a play that I think she's going to try to go into Kelsey Buchanan. But going into Kelsey Buchanan on the block, they don't want an outside shot unless it's Courtney Green at the three. They'll take that. But they're going to try to pound it inside and get a good look.
Hens shooting just 33% in the second half, 37% for the game. The inbound far sideline, Akima Richards to Erica Brown. 24 on the timer, she feeds left wing to Green. Green driving towards the basket, picking up her bounce, feeding off near corner Richards. Richards jabs towards the lane, now out to Green, head fake drive to the foul line, scoops it up, hit the side of the backboard, then ripped it away from Creighton. Are they going to call a foul on Green? They are. And so we'll walk the length. Creighton will shoot free throws. That's a good call. It just came really late. Contact was initial, and there was no whistle. And then when Green ripped it free, he decided to call the foul. I think he might want to watch a football game later today. It might be the first call he's made all day long.
Yeah, and this is where those fouls really get critical. You know, Drexel. I got the crowd noise, though.
National Football League's AFC Conference Championship with 3 minutes to go. First quarter.
Did you hear?
Denver Broncos 3, New England Patriots nothing.
Being able to pull away from Delaware here. Not sure what has all of a sudden after that power outage issue, things kind of went the wrong way. So unfortunately now as they check the clock, it is a 58-48 game, 57-6-10. Talking back to our producer, Andrew Robertson, if he could switch us back to the ISDN line, we'll pause 10 seconds and come back to the headset with Delaware down 10.
Passionate about sports.
I bring so it back. Well. Fade out of the. Bring it back.
22-yard scoring strike, a perfect throw.
Andrew, here we go back at the Carpenter Center. Apologies again for the technical difficulties. 40 seconds left. The Hens get it inside. They miss a layup. Rebound grab by Drexel. They foul in the backcourt. Flanagan will walk the length and shoot two free throws. Christine, welcome you back in with the technical problems fixed. A weird final 3 minutes to this one. Unfortunately, the Hens
could not get it back there after they had drawn to within four with about 4 minutes to go.
Yeah, and they had cut it to three, and then Drexel came down and hit another three, increasing it to six as she hits her first free throw, and Denise Dillon calling her Drexel team back to just get off the free throw line. And when the power outage happened, it actually kind of took the air out of that momentum where Delaware was cruising.
All right, so the second free throw good, and pair knocked down for Creighton, down 12 with 35 seconds left. It's not going to go Delaware's way. Is Green dribbling left wing, feeding corner to Richards. Richards drives baseline, lays it home. 26 and 5/10 left. Delaware will pick up full court. We'll see if they foul here. Inbound goes to Pearson, back pass to Flanagan, over the top, nice feed to Reddick. And then Buchanan gives a hard foul. I think some frustration there from Kelsey Buchanan, which is very out of character. You do not see that from KB too often, one of the nicest human beings you're ever going to come across. But with 21 and 1/10 seconds left against your rival down 10, you can understand it.
And they've been going at it down low. There has been a lot of banging around, even though a lot of the fouls haven't been called as Abby Riddick hits her first free throw. But, you know, this Delaware team, they were fighting and fighting, but just couldn't come up with those possessions the way Drexel was able to. Drexel converted, and Delaware was one and done.
It's an experienced team versus a young team, unfortunately. Mm-hmm. Second free throw, no good. Hens get the rebound. Brown the other way, dribbling into the forecourt, off balance towards the basket, floated it up, wouldn't go. Offensive board, Buchanan, blind follow, sidearm got it in. But it just gets it to a 9-point game, 6 seconds left. The inbound goes to Creighton. Tina Martin says don't foul, and Drexel will dribble this one out. So finally the Dragons able to slay their rivals as they take this one this afternoon by the final score of 61-52.
And what did Tina Martin say to us before the game? They need to keep Drexel in the 50s if they have a chance of winning this game. Drexel gets to 61 and able to defeat the Hens by 9.
For a long stretch of the second half, it was played at Delaware's tempo. The Hens got back in it, but it went the other way late. So the final 61-52, we'll take a timeout, come back with all your post-game coverage here from the Bob in Newark. Once again, Drexel, a 61-52 winner over Delaware.